Hey, what's up? All right, got a crazy one for y'all today. Let's get into it. All right, I'm gonna demonstrate how to get detail from one thing and transfer it to another. And just to show an extreme example of that, this is using layers, by the way. This is using layers, project history, and morph target mainly. But yeah, let's get into it. So this is an extreme example. I used a normal map to grab detail here. This is a model that this is a warframe model, but you'll see here it's actually two warframe models. But I used layers to kind of like project around, and again, like this was kind of difficult, to be honest. I'm not sure that I would do this again. I just wanted to see if I could do it, and I managed to, but I wanted to get his detail and morph it into her shape and get it, on her UVs. The problem I was having at first was it was really light like that. It wasn't it was maintaining the detail, but it wasn't getting any of those secondary forms, so I ended up baking a displacement and storing that in a layer to get, more of the secondary shaped like this. So, I did this a while back, guys, and when I came in here to show this, all my layers aren't even named. Name your layers, 'cause I didn't know what was going on. All right. I wish I would have named them. Anyways, so I'm gonna demonstrate that on a more simple thing, and just step through it with you guys. So this is the same skin, just different subtool. But this model in particular has several different pieces, and I had already detailed one, which was this large shoulder here. So I wanted to get that and just transfer it over to this because they're different topologies. So first thing I did was store history on the big shoulder. Anywhere I had it, so I adjusted the poly paint and stuff a little bit, and then I came up here. You control click on your history bar wherever you want to store that because I'm going to be projecting it. Something to note, if you are on ZBrush 2023.2 or above, your morph target is going to be stored with your undo history, and I am very curious how that would affect this. I know that at the worst, it would cause it maybe to not be possible, but I'm pretty sure that it is. I think the only thing that's going to happen is it's going to make it a little bit like back and forth with storing your history to get a morph target and stuff. Because from what I understand, if you have a morph target stored via regular means, and then you store your history, it's going to use the history rather than the morph target. And I'm not sure if that applies to like having separate, like the history stored on one subtool and the morph target on another in this case. So just let me know, guys, if you actually watch this and you like it and you use this, then let me know if the or just let me know in general how do the morph targets work in 2023.2 and above that, because I'm not sure. Like, that's an awesome feature to have it tied to the history, but I'm not sure that there's a lot of things I use that that's gonna mess with. So I'm just curious. But anyways, let's go on with this. So all right, let's. So now that I've stored the history, so that's step one: store history on the thing you want the detail from. All right, so since this is in a different position, I'm just gonna stage it at home and move it linearly over. And I'm just gonna step through the undo history here, guys. I did this beforehand, so I could just step through the undo history and give you all the steps straight up and quick. So I subdivide up, okay? And then I set a home and target stage there and there. Okay, so that's all I've done so far. I just subdivided the shape and stored a home and a target, and also I stored a morph target at this point. Okay, and then I started recording a layer. Let's see. So yeah, morph target is stored. Now we're going to start recording our. Also, ignore this timeline, guys. I don't. That popped down. That's has nothing to do with this right now. Something at the end I'll show with it, but has nothing to do with this shoulder piece. So yeah, morph target while it's smooth, before you've done anything. All I have is home stage, target stage, because when this is done and the layers are baked, I want to move it back. That's why I did the stager there. If it's in the same spot, then it just doesn't matter, then don't worry about stager at all. So the important things to know are store morph target while it's smooth and in the shape, the original shape. Okay. Now I'm going to record a layer and you're going to see me start to move this around, and that's just to get it inflated a little bit. And I bent it around to kind of engulf that large shoulder. Let me go up here to V3 so you can see a little better. All right. So we're going to engulf that larger shoulder there. And then I project the history, guys. So I only project it at a lower level, and that's just to get it, you know, I projected it once and it wasn't grabbing everything. So I upped the distance on the projection. And if you don't know where that is, that's a subtool menu, project history. Okay. And it's pulling it from the thing that we stored the history on, the big shoulder. So I only projected it, I think, twice, maybe. I went up another subdivision level, projected it, maybe smoothed it out a bit and projected it again, dropped back down and projected it, and then I divided all the way up. Okay, divided all the way up, stop recording that layer. All right, and then I named that layer to shape, because I want to know that's the first layer and that's just the rough shape transformation. So if I toggle that layer off, which I'm not going to do because I'll lose my history, it would revert back to the other shape. And I have my morph target stored just in case, so I can get it, you know, get the original shape back if I needed to. So now with that layer visible, we're going to do an adjustment layer, meaning recording a new layer while that one is visible. And now I'm going to project all of it. I step down my subdivisions, project the history again, project it again and again. And so basically the process is all the way from the lowest subdivision level, project history, go up a subdivision level, project history, go up and repeat until you have the detail. So there we go. And I smoothed it out a little bit, but that I ended up projecting it one more time. And then I was like, I'm not going to smooth it. So here's the key. Once you've done that, guys, you take your shape layer and you can just turn the visibility off on it. You'll see that I stepped down slowly, and I did that because I wanted you to see it move, because I think it's cool. But yeah, so now it's back at its original shape, and now you'll see that I bake the layers, because now no more layers. So if you hit bake all, that gets rid of your layers. Note, I still have the morph target stored. So if I wanted to like go all the way back, I could just run a morph target over this and it would be back to its original smooth subdivided shape with none of the changes. And that's why I feel like that being stored to the history might not be as easy to do this, but I still think it's possible. And you'll see that there what happened was I just morphed the I baked the layers, guys. I stay away from poly paint when I'm in layers, because it works differently. You can erase poly paint and stuff with layers. It gets a little complicated. So I just projected the collar onto it after, without layers, and then morphed it back to the other shape. And what happened was there, in case you got confused, because that confused me a little bit as well. at some point. Yeah. So I deleted my morph target. Okay, guys. Right here. Because I knew I wanted to project the only reason I did that is because I wanted my morph target here now, because I wanted to be able to switch back after I grabbed the collar. That's what it was. So that's not necessary unless you just want to grab the poly paint. So that's why I did that. And then switch stage after baking the layers. Don't switch the stages while you're in the layers. It gets weird. But that's it, guys. Like, literally, move it into place. It's two layers. Project the shape, smooth it a bit, then project the detail, turn off the shape layer. Okay? And then you have literally your detail. It might be neat adjusted here and there. Like, you can see it's stretched here. It's because it's trying to conform the detail to another shape. But if I turn it back on, I mean, yeah, I'm going to work on this more, but it's an awesome place to start, and it's really quick to do once you get the hang of it. It's kind of confusing at first, but if you do it a couple times, I promise it's easy and fast. So, yeah, I just, there was so much on layers already out there, guys. Like, when I YouTubed it, I just wanted to take what was already out there with, like, smoothing and inversing to get more detail. And just kind of try to push further what's already out there. I don't know if somebody surely knows how to do this, but it's really cool, I think. So, hey, listen, I hope this helps. And before I close this video out, I just want to show you guys something that I did with layers with a bunch of spheres. And that's why I have this thing up here. I did this crazy, ridiculous animation, and this just, like, this is a bunch of spheres. I moved them all in, recorded the animation and with layers, and projected this face sculpt that I did onto a ton of spheres, and you can see it's, like, kind of messed up, but still I think it was cool. Anyways, that's just to show pure, like, literally show off the power, how powerful layers are. So, alright, man, I hope this was helpful, guys. I think I use it a lot. I used it in a project recently to get detail from this to this. Sorry. Not that. Well, it's that piece, but I wanted a different shape, and yeah. So, you know, I transferred the detail to that, and then I ended up messing with it a little bit more. All right, so that's it for this one, guys. I really hope it helps. Peace out.